Welcome to We Don't Have Cookies with your host, Jason Marshall.
Welcome to the February's Dumbass of the Year episode. Joining me today is the man who will be joining me for all of these episodes from now on. It's the one and only Benny Mack. Welcome to the podcast, man. It's great to have you here.
Oh, it is an absolute pleasure to be here. I'm so excited. Dumbass of the Year. I'm being a... Being a dumbass, some of the time, hey, I've got a bit of experience with Dumbass of the Year, so I think I'm a good judge of character for that.
Why don't you go ahead and tell the listeners a little bit about yourself?
My name's Benny Mack. You can check me out on Twitter. But basically, I'm a live streamer, and I do a bit of a variety of live broadcasting. I also work in the film and TV industry in New Zealand, and I'm excited to be here. But enough about me. Let's talk about some real dumbasses.
Well, before we get into that, I got two quick topics to go over with you, if you don't mind.
Let's do it.
Something that we talked about on the show a few months ago was KFC put out a fried chicken scented candle, but it was only available in New Zealand. Did you see any of those?
I did not manage to get my hands on that product, unfortunately. No. It was not made available to me.
It sounds great, but because I was going to go out and look for one and maybe do a video about it or something. But then when I found out they were only available there, do you guys eat a lot of fried chicken? Is there a reason why they would just say, hey, New Zealand is the target market for a fried chicken scented candle?
Wow, that's a great question. We do eat a lot of fried chicken. I mean, I had fried chicken today. Oh, really? I had more than one type of fried chicken today.
No kidding.
You know what I'm saying?
What types did you have?
Frozen. I had a frozen variety. And I had a fresh style variety. What are those bites things? Balls? They're like little tater tots, but they're like got some sort of chicken in there.
Oh, popcorn chicken.
Oh, yeah. I fried my own damn fried chicken. I got one of those. I got that. What do they call that oil? Canola oil?
Yeah.
It's good for the heart muscle.
Mm-hmm.
That's it's a good for the heart lining. So you use the vegetable oil. Don't use no animal fat. Use canola oil. Fry it all nice. Put that popcorn chicken on there. Eat all different kinds of fried chicken. Maybe cook it yourself. Maybe buy it. Maybe have someone fry it for you. Maybe put it into a candle and aromatize the room. I don't know. I don't know who marketed this stuff to me. All I know is I like it. I want it. I couldn't get a hold of it. My man Jason Marshall had the same problem. We got to get it stateside.
Yeah.
We got to ship these candles stateside. That's whack that they're not going to send out this wax.
I have one more question for you. I had some people on from Canada last Thursday, and we were going over how you pronounce the letter Z or Z. And just casually, the guy said, you should ask somebody from New Zealand that, because he said in Canada, they said Zed, UK says Zed, and he had no idea that you were coming up this Thursday. So I told him I would ask you that. How do you pronounce it in New Zealand? Z or Zed?
That's a great question. NZ.
Zed, huh?
We'd say, welcome to New Zealand. Welcome to NZ. But if we wanted to get all fancy, welcome to NZ, baby. But hey, it doesn't matter what you say or how you say it, man. It's just that you got to say that NZ or NZ. It's all sexy. One way it's all smancy like that, and the other way it's all classy. Mix it up.
I like it. Got to give it to the NZ.
NZ. Let it be said, NZ. Wait and see about NZ. Check up on that. It's how you want to say it. I'm not sure. Like X, Y, Z. It just sounds funny, right?
Yeah.
When you're singing it.
I can't think of any other letter where you add extra
X, Y, Z. It's easy like A, B, C, X, Y, Z.
That would be like calling the letter A, Abe or something. Why would you add extra letters for a pronunciation for one letter? It's very weird.
Well, in Australia, have you heard of H or H?
No.
H. The letter H.
Huh.
Ask an Australian about the letter H, dude. That'll freak you out.
Are you serious? I will do that next week.
Mate, gonna switch on the HDTV, mate. Oh, it's fucking hot in here.
There's a guy who does
HD.
There's a guy who does a segment for the podcast. He lives in Australia. I'll have to ask him about that.
Ask him. H. Why did they say H? It's because they don't want to pronounce the H, the word that pronounces the letter H with an A starting word. H. A-C-H-E. H. I've got a fucking H in my back. Oh, my back's got a back H. Ah, achy. I don't know. It's funny. Anyway.
The first dumbass we're going to get to this week, this month, it went out to an entire police station in Workington, England. They blew up a car that was parked in front of the police station by their own police officers who belonged to a man who they were giving medical attention to and took to a hospital.
Classic Homeland Security blunder.
It looks like, at the very least, they would have just went over the security camera footage to see who got out of the car and then realized, like, uniform officers that can be verified as working there were the ones doing this.
So the Worthington Police Force, the whole damn squad got the award.
Yeah. Yeah, because
I reckon they're stupid. I reckon they're a whole load of dumbasses. They should have gone over the security camera footage. You're right. You're entirely right. You got to search the footage. You got to look for the clues. You got to open an investigation. You don't start laying C4 dynamite and imploding that shit. It ain't no inside job. It's not a false flag event. It's a medical emergency. Help the poor man. Don't try and take his livelihood.
This poor man's laying in the hospital and his car gets blown up. It couldn't have had a worse day.
Man, he just wanted his day fixed. He didn't want no liability.
The only thing that could have been worse is if he just happened to withdraw all his money to take somewhere to buy another car or to just put it in a different bank. But for some reason, just happened to have it all that one time.
He did. I heard he had a duffel bag. He had a duffel bag full of unmarked bills. And it got imploded. And, man, it was raining. It was raining dollar bills up in there.
Well, speaking of money, that is our second dumbass of the year. It was a man who stole $7 billion in 70 wire transfers because Jesus wanted him to be wealthy.
I can see that. That was Jesus wants me to be Jesus wants me to be very wealthy. $7 billion?
Yeah.
And he wired it.
Right. It's 70 transfers.
That's a technical crime. He should be commended. That's a technical crime. That's not a problem. He should get a job for the feds. He could teach them a thing or two about money laundering the right way.
You're right.
The
about
Jesus
that.
Way. No tax. It's religious, no tax, man. The brethren get a percentage.
He's a money laundering prophet. You would
man,
think.
Man, oh, man. He's a prophet of the Lord. See that? Let it be done.
Doing that in just 70 wire transfers, you don't think that's going to raise a red flag somewhere?
Damn, that was a red flag event if ever I saw one. If that isn't going to raise a few flags, I don't know what is. And how is he going to be spending that money? Maybe he's doing a little investment in the UAE.
for his sake, I hope he put it somewhere offshore. At least some.
Damn. You want to set up a non-profit in the Caymans, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Get into that palm oil and those bonds. Get a hold of some of those bonds. Shit.
The third one?
$7 billion?
Yeah.
$7 billion, you said?
$7 billion.
All right, all right. I'll write that down. I need to take a note of that one. Jesus sent me here.
That's incredible. I mean, if it was just $7 million, that's a lot of money. But if you did it over 70 wire transfers, depending who you did it to, you might be able to get away with it. But when you're talking $7 billion, that's a couple of million each wire transfer. You're going to get busted.
I want to know how much the Pope Benedict got a hold of. Is that his name? They keep changing popes every 5 minutes over there.
Yeah, I
don't. With the Illuminati. Anyway, don't get me started on the damn Illuminati.
The third dumbass of the year for the month of February is a Canadian driver. He drove his car into a streetcar tunnel, one of the little trolleys, because he was following his GPS. And that's where it said to go. No personal responsibility, no looking at all the very obvious do not enter signs. and the tracks in front of you instead of a road. The fact that it was going underground and everything else is above ground. None of that raised a flag. Just went straight in there. And then he took off running. Just left the car.
What? Did he get it stuck?
Yeah, he got it stuck, and then he took off, and they had to get a crane to go in and take it out.
Damn. Did the streetcar run into it?
No. They were able to figure out what was going on before. That was what I was wondering, too.
Thank God. Yeah. All right. Damn. All right. Well.
So out of those three. Who do you think is the least dumbass of those three? It's kind of a hard
The guy
choice.
That got all the cash, the $7 billion man, he's smart.
Yeah.
That guy's, I need to meet that guy. I need to get a hold of that guy's business plan. I need to find out about all that hidden investment he's got in the Caymans. That guy's not dumbass. That guy's a genius.
You're right, because he had to scout out who he was going to do this to. You can't just hit anybody up for that amount of money. You have to have a
maybe
plan.
He robbed Google. And maybe he robbed, what's his name? Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. Ooh. I don't know. There's a lot of money there.
Yeah, you're right about that. Right. So
he's pretty smart. So yeah. I like that guy.
So that leaves us with the Canadian driver and the entire police force in Workington, England.
Oh, man.
Personally, I'm going to have to go with the police station that blew up a car and didn't even bother to verify their employee.
I think you're right. They didn't even launch an investigation.
No, they just came straight.
They didn't even look at a tape. Damn, all they had to do was rewind the tape.
Yeah, they just destroyed this man's car. And the worst part is, he was legitimately in the hospital. They actually brought him in and put him in a room.
He had a medical emergency. He didn't need this problem. He needed a solution. He wasn't looking for a whole new set of problems. Damn. Oh, damn.
So you
agree? I believe the Worthington Police Force in England, in the United Kingdom, formerly known as the Empire of Brittany, over there in little old place they call Europe. I think they're so stupid. They just want to play with fireworks. They just want to use that, you know, in the evidence locker. They had a whole lot of C4 explosives out here that they just wanted to use it on up.
You know,
they just wanted to light it up. And they were trying to do it for social media exposure.
I would to think that that's true. There's just some guy over there, some bumbling cop that doesn't really know what he's doing, but he really wants to blow shit up.
And
he spent the whole time just trying to talk people into it.
He saw that guy with the heart attack, you know? Mm-hmm. He was trying to save that guy, and he said he palmed him off. He palmed that victim off, and he blew up his shit. Oh, man.
He said, here's my chance. The witness that owns this car is gone. I'll just tell him I think
it's a
bomb. Create
a false flag event. That's right. Say it's an act of terrorism. National security is at risk. It's a false flag event. It could be Muslim. I'm not saying that. But, yeah, he wanted to light it up, that's for sure.
Yeah, it's
wanted to bring some fire.
It's incredible that they didn't even bother to try to figure anything out, just went straight to blowing up the car. It's unreal, man. I think it was in England. It might have been somewhere in America, but there was a bicycle that had "My Bike is a Pipe Bomb" bumper sticker on it, which apparently is the name of a band. And it was parked outside of some store. The police saw it and came and blew the bike up. They didn't even get a chance to talk to the person that owned it. They just freaked out because they saw the bumper sticker. And that was how that went. That was pretty bizarre. Damn. Man.
I like what the cops have got over there in America. They got these little robots.
Mm-hmm.
And then what they are is they're the little crawling bulldozer bot. And they've got the top, they got the gooseneck, and they got the hook. So what they do is they crawl up on the bomb. The gooseneck hooks up and looks around at the bomb. It scans the bomb with the laser. And then there's the guy in the suit. He's got the clipper. He runs out there with the clipper, diffuses the bomb. Hey, I don't know if it's a bike. Maybe he cuts the brakes on the bike. Shit, I don't know. But maybe in those tires, just maybe it's got some sort of lethal gas. I don't know. People were too paranoid out there about trying to blow stuff up. Even the police can't park a car in the street no more. Damn, you probably even put money in the meter.
He just gently cuts each spoke, just in case.
Just cut the spokes, man. Yeah.
You never know. There could be wires in there.
Damn. That's the thing, eh? Bike safety. They could have just, you know, unlocked the bike, rolled it away.
Just roll it into a lake.
Damn. Hey, but hey, that's a lesson for everybody. Be super considerate when you put a sticker on your car. Don't put nothing offensive on the car. Don't put nothing offensive on the car. Don't have no false flag on the car. We don't need that. We don't need to waste the time, the money, the effort of the community. Trying to build the community up. We're not trying to blow the damn pipe back up. Shit.
That's a good point, man. That's a good note to go out on. I want to thank you for being on the show. I'm looking forward to having you on again in March. Is there anything that you'd like to promote before we go?
Keep your eyes to the skies. Nah, I've got no promotions right now. But everybody, promote yourself. Give yourself a pat on the back. Peace.
All right, man. You have a good night. And everybody listening, tomorrow there will be a bonus episode with Mama Kate. Thanks for listening. Keep spreading the word. And I'll talk to you guys tomorrow.
Thanks for listening. Tell your friends about the show and leave a review.
Balls.